Hello, I'm Curtis Padley. How are we all doing?
Oh no, my video has been hijacked.
It has been ruined.
Hello, hello, and welcome to York. I'm near a blue door. I probably should have stood in front of something a little bit more York. But here we are, near the blue door. I am with the very talented Curtis Padley. I will link his channel below, above, wherever links go. I've got my GoPro on, so I'm gonna go take some photographs with my camera. We're shooting with the FujiFilm X100V today, and let's not go any further, let's just go into it.
We are starting today's video in this alleyway, near this Mini that I have now missed because I was recording this part, dang it. Please don't run me over.
See in her eyes how much she wanted it.
She was ready. Got this amazing view of York Minster just lovingly put between these two rows of buildings. It's so cool. The York Minster is such a cool building. And then you've got the blue sky, the sun flare, the clouds. Beautiful. Look at that beautiful sky. And because it's so bright, the green of the grass is very green. Good commentary, Jack. The colour is very colour. Look at that building nested between the trees. Just, I love it. It's amazing. That guy was running. Now this is the garden they grow the rocks in that they built the Minster out of. Very cool. I love seeing these like insect hotels. They're always awesome to look at. They're so creative as well. And obviously it's good to be nice to bugs. Can you really walk past flowers without taking photos of them? I mean, I can't, so.
I am an influencer, okay? I drive a Vauxhall Corsa, admittedly. That's my house.
This is my influencer Corsa?
Yeah.
This building looks amazing from every single angle. I'm basically sitting down on the floor for this shot, but it just looks so cool. Just walking backwards down this alley, because the further back this way I get, the cooler this shot looks, and I'm trying to find that sweet spot where it looks as cool as it can look. These little back streets in York are so cool, especially when it's been raining and there are big old puddles everywhere, because you can get really cool looking reflections. I love this, just ahead there. I'm gonna get run over. So I love this, right? So you've got this tower here that's part of the wall, and then you've got this lovely puddle down here with the double yellow lines leading through it. Just get that really nice reflection.
Can't do much street portraiture with this lens, but...
Let's give this one a try, see what we can get. No, this window is huge, and the symmetry is lovely. Just talking about the scaffolding on the York Minster, and it actually makes quite a cool photo, especially because it's in half of it and not in the other half. And especially because the sky is very angry. Basically every single street in York has just been gorgeous so far today. So Curtis is showing me a few different places to take photos in York while I'm here today, because he knows this better than I do. But basically all he's done so far today is nearly lay down in every puddle he's seen. Oh, do you know what? I think he's onto something with this puddle.
I know my puddles in York.
It's a little bit too busy to get this cleanly, but that tree at the end of this street, in between the buildings, looks very cool. We're here at the Shambles now, and it looks like it was purpose-built to be adorable and extremely busy. That was entirely too many people, so that's as far into that as we're getting. The lanterns there with the writing and the trees in the background, it's just really nice colour contrast. The lit up lantern with the string lights in the background, look at that, like that lovely depth of field there as well. It's just gorgeous. I thought while I'm out being a tourist, I'd come and see this tower. It wasn't covered in scaffolding the last time I was here. Although, that said, with the cool sky, it does look really cool. There's this old iron fence here. You've got the paint is chipping off, and all you can see through these little holes in the bottom are weeds, right? It sounds terrible, but I really like it. I love these little red boats in York. I really want to go rent one out. This looks really cool with the buildings and the moody sky as well. Excuse me, red boat. Could you go under the middle? Under the middle bit, please. Don't go under the side, middle.
Don't
better shot.
That boat. That one.
Oh, they're going for it.
We can't
sinks.
Make a decision.
Help. Beautiful. Magnifique. That is a very cool alleyway. I'm just going to shimmy up a little bit further so we're past a lot of the litter.
I did my bit.
We should get that over there. That's fine. Stay there. You look really cool.
Oh, sorry. Get, you want me to stay?
Yeah, get back there. Get back. Yeah. I love taking photos of people taking photos. You've got the clock tower here nested between these two buildings, which is then further nested in between these plants. This actually might be a cool location for a panning shot, so I'll see what I can get as it comes past here. It's going to be quite a narrow window though. Get the boat between the plants under the bridge. Look at that, lovely framing. Had to run for the shot because Look at that, I love that. I love this frame here for the red boat with the green frame, looks really cool.
Look at this, it's an ant shot. New type of shot coming to a pub near you.
Just delicious, look. It's got everything you need. It's got alcohol, it's in a plastic glass, there's protein from the bugs. Disgusting. We are up on the walls of York now. This is a beautiful historic place covered in scaffolding, like every other beautiful historic place today. Again though, it still looks really cool. So where we've actually got the sun is back out. Oh, pigeon. That was a fast pigeon. Oh my God, I nearly died. As we've got the sun is out now, everything is beautiful and shiny. You've got these really cool looking shadows cast along the wall. I mean, there's nothing special, but it just looks really pretty. This house with the plants and the orange door just bathed in sunlight is so nice. It's just very, very picturesque. This is another fantastic view of the Minster. You've got these leading lines around from the wall. I was going to say bridge, but it's not a bridge, it's a wall. They're different things. It's framed nicely between the buildings and the plants. The sky is amazing. Sometimes it is just so good to take the tourist photos. I love it. I'm going to nip to the other side of the...
Oh, dude.
I'm going to go to the other side.
My voice is cracked.
To the other side, bus. So through the, I don't know what these holes are called, but through these holes on the bridge, I want to get a photo of one of the red boats that keeps going up and down the river. Everywhere you go in York City Centre, you've got the Minster framed really nicely. And actually, where the sun's catching it at the moment, it really stands out. I have seen this building many, many times before. I have seen it several times today, in fact, and it is still ridiculously awesome. Oh my goodness, look at this chunky pigeon. I really want a photo of the chunky pigeon. Come here. Come here, little fella. You look really cool against the red door. No, don't do it. Do you think this pub is called Forest because it's covered in greenery? Or do you think it's covered in greenery because it's called Forest? Here is one of York's year-round Christmas shops. Yep, that's right. You didn't mishear me. He does, he looks very, very disinterested, doesn't he? It couldn't decide which face to focus on. How has this Nutcracker man collected all of the Infinity Stones 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times? He should have ruled the universe by now. I like this radio tower against the moody sky, especially with the brick buildings in front of it. It looks quite, I don't know, end of the worldy almost. One of the best things about York is the free claustrophobia. Jokes aside, that is a cool staircase to get you back up onto the wall. So this will be the last section of the POV today. We're having a last little walk around the walls and looking, shockingly, at the Minster. there is nowhere that you cannot escape. The Minster is everywhere. The Minster knows all. The Minster sees all. Listen, guys, I know that I have said the sentence, look how nicely the Minster is framed here, but look how nicely the Minster is framed here. Okay. Can I say it one more time? Look how nicely the Minster is framed here. It's just tucked in the trees. There's a bit of blue in the sky now. Not a lot, mind, but there's a bit. Walking along the wall, it generally has been cool views of the Minster, as you well know. But this part, look at this. This is like we're in some sort of forest. I mean, maybe we are. What's the classification for a forest? How many trees does it need? Because there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are a lot of trees. Oh, look at that. That's a cool shot of the street through the window. Is it a window? Yes. That is it. We are running out of daylight. It has gotten incredibly windy and we're fast approaching time for me to go and get a train home. This has been an amazing day. I have loved taking photos. Hanging out with Curtis has been great. He's down there. Don't read too much into that.
I'm grabbing a gander.
Thank you again so much for watching. Go subscribe to Curtis's channel, because he's better at this than I am.
I wouldn't say that much.
Curtis, have you got any of your closing remarks?
Great shooting with you again, mate. Hopefully you can do it again soon.
Yeah, there we go. Perfect. I hope you have enjoyed the video and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye. Again, thank you so much for watching. That was a really fun video to make. I don't really know how to end them. Kind of ended quite abruptly. Need to figure that out. If you want to see me figure that out, you should subscribe just in case I do it in another video. Goodbye.